From Tampa Bay streaming news leader, this is ABC Action News.
I'm Lauren Rosella. You'll want to keep your umbrella close by once again today. Jason Adams has a look at when you could see a break in the rain. Finally. But in the meantime, all the rain we've been getting is causing some problems in Port Richey's Gulf Highlands neighborhood. Their streets are flooded. Pasco leaders say the sewer system is clogged because it just can't handle the rain. Also, a retention pond in the area is overflowing. The county says crews are working to fix it as fast as they can. Pasco County is one of several places in the Bay Area offering sandbags. Now, we have a full list of the cities and counties with locations open this weekend on our website, abcactionnews.com. A man accused of severely beating a woman, you see him right there, in Brooksville has been arrested. At last check, she is still in the hospital with critical injuries. The Hernando County Sheriff's Office says the crime happened at the Freedom Garden Apartments yesterday morning. Investigators say the two had just met. And troopers need your help finding the driver that crashed into a group of people walking. Two died, one of them just 13 years old. Investigators say four people were walking along US 19 around 2:30 Saturday morning. That's when a white pickup truck traveling in the same direction hit three of them. The driver didn't stop. Troopers say they are now looking for a white Chevy Silverado they think was made between 2003 and 2007. And if you know anything, please call Star FHP. Now we want to get right over to Jason Adams, who's tracking another round of rain today. Jason.
And the good news is it's not going to be as widespread as what we've been seeing the last couple of days. Today's kind of the transition day from our very soggy pattern we've been in for about a week and a half now to a more typical rainy pattern for Florida at this time of year, which means more sunshine and gradually lower rain chances. However, today we're starting out with morning coastal showers followed by a few scattered thunderstorms later on. Rain chances running 60% north of I-4 and around 40% south of I-4. So it's not the widespread 80 to 90% rain chance coverage like we've had the last few days. So it's getting a little bit better for us. But as we go from today into tomorrow, again, a few scattered storms with temperatures up to near 90. But Monday, winds come in from the Atlantic side of the peninsula. That is an east wind. And what that means for us is that we'll see drier conditions in the morning with mostly sunny skies, temperatures heating back up into the lower 90s. And then those afternoon sea breeze storms come in from the Atlantic side all the way back over towards the Gulf. So we are transitioning back to a more typical pattern for us for this time of year, Lauren.
All right, that's great news, Jason. And you can get news updates all day long on your favorite streaming device. And don't forget to download the free ABC Action News mobile app.